Hey, this is about mantras, and I love this group because I'm sitting here super early in the morning out on my desk. Yes, I'm wearing my Wonder Woman pajamas, but I can do that with you girls because we're fam, so no judgment. I just felt that this was the perfect time to address today's topic, which is mantras, and I'm sure the word mantra conjures up some stuff for you. Maybe it's good, maybe it's not so good, maybe it's like woo craziness, but I want to put it in the context of how it's going to help you manage your cortisol because that is the goal. I have some mantras that I literally write down every morning and I try to feel them in my bones, and I know that it sets me up for a day where I again am controlling my hormones. And this is exactly what's going to happen. As women, we experience the feelings of failure like a record number of times a day, more so than our male counterparts. It's just the way that we were designed. And those feelings of failure aren't just in our heads, right? There's a chemical response to that. We usually experience, these feelings of like inadequacy, like we didn't do enough. We didn't get the kids to school on time. We didn't, we didn't, we didn't. And it always just perpetuates this feeling of failure. Girls, I totally know that you know what I'm talking about. And what that does is every time we experience failure, we actually raise our testosterone. And when we raise our testosterone, again, our hormones talk to each other. So if one hormone is high, another one's got to go low. And guess what goes low? Our progesterone, our estrogen. And when those more female hormones go low, unfortunately, it sets off a negative cascade, and our cortisol levels don't flush out properly, and we don't secrete as much serotonin, which is a feel-good hormone. And I'll talk more about that with nutrition and its relationship to cortisol. But the bottom line is this: here's how you can combat it. You want to secrete less testosterone. Well, you want to feel less feelings of failure, and we all want to let go of that, right? Mantras are a great way to do that, and especially early in the morning. So first thing, you get up and you just want to say things to yourself that empower you, right? Because we set that negative tape off all day, and we say like really shitty stuff to ourselves. You got to cut that out, and the best way to do that is to literally create new habits by forming new neural pathways in the brain. A lot of what you say to yourself is just habit. You've been saying it to yourself for 30 plus years, and it's not even an awareness anymore. Stop, slow down, find the awareness first of what shitty stuff you are saying to yourself. And then take those crappy things. I'm fat, I'm this, I'm ugly, I can't do everything, I'm a loser. Like all these things that you might be saying to yourself. Write them down. Pick five or six that you feel like you say all the time. Write them down. And then literally write the opposite. And that's your mantra. And practice. It's going to take some practice, just like exercise takes some practice. Every time you catch yourself saying the negative, turn it into the positive, and then keep repeating that. But also writing down those mantras every single morning. Just even for the 2 weeks of this challenge, write them down every morning, repeat them throughout the day, feel them in your bones, feel them in your heart, and it will absolutely help you manage your cortisol levels, and it's going to just make you feel a hell of a lot better. Mantras, baby, get after it.